Luke, come here. Come see Grandma. Come on. Should we go real high? Woo!
I think most of our citizens would be appalled if they realized that 41 other countries do a better job of keeping their babies alive than we do in the United States.
No, you can't go standing up.
When I had my babies, I was in the hospital 7 days, and my youngest son is 26. When he was born, I think it was down to 3 or 4 days. And so I imagined, as I was a hospital nursery nurse, that I'm sending home all these babies to a little pink and blue nursery and a mom and a dad, because that was my reality, and that was the reality of the people I associated with. I didn't know what was behind the doors of the poor. It's very hard if you lack the resources to be able to care for yourself, to suddenly be able to care for a baby as well.
Now we really got to talk about safety issues.
Babies were dying of preventable causes, and I was so just absolutely emotionally destroyed watching a baby die in his mother's arms. And she was wondering, what did she do wrong? And she didn't do anything wrong. Our healthcare system did something wrong. It was very difficult to take the risk to start nurses for newborns. I was in a job that I truly loved, and I'd been there 17 years, and I never intended to leave.
Father God, we just lift up to you, baby John.
And I thought, I was so spiritual because I would lay hands on each baby and I would pray for each baby, and I thought, oh look, God's using me and I'm making really good money too, and it's pretty easy, this is great. And yet, when I saw babies dying in the emergency room, I felt that I needed to do something to stop that because I didn't see anybody else doing anything.
Oh, very interesting.
Okay, oh, Dr. Orphy, when did she do that?
It was 50 years old, and my daughter convinced me to start a nonprofit entity, and that's Nurses for Newborns Foundation today. And that would allow us to serve the poor.
Now, essentially 9 months old, but she's developmentally about only 5. Okay, she's achieved some.
I thought that the problem was how long they stayed in the hospital. But once I actually got behind those doors, and most of us don't have a reason to go behind those doors in the poor neighborhoods. And I realized, you know, there were 13 people in 3 rooms. There was no formula. There were no diapers. The parents had no parenting skills.
But when I left the hospital, I couldn't believe I'm taking a baby home.
I bet you couldn't. She had something called necrotizing enterocolitis, where parts of the bowel actually die.
She was 29 weeks, and she weighed 2 pounds and 11 ounces. She's doing fine now. Yeah.
Okay. She's pulling things toward me, and she's pulling me toward her.
Yeah.
Okay. And her lungs are clear.
Our program is really half lay ministry and half skilled nursing.
I brought you a few things.
Many of our mothers are in crisis, and we meet them in a very difficult place in their lives.
And that's what we want her to do.
But I think by showing love and understanding to them, I think it's one of the most important things that we can do.
It just means so much to me just to have someone to talk to, because at first I didn't have anybody to talk to, not even my mother.
I'm glad I can be there for you, honey.
Thank you.
Today, our organization has a $3.6 million budget per year. We have to raise $8,000 a day. And if I had known that in the beginning, I probably would have run screaming in the opposite direction. But somehow, it is provided. My work is far from finished. That's why I'm not sitting in a rocking chair with my grandchildren, but keeping on.
He's sick.
No. We really need to address infant mortality in our communities.
I can't feel my hands anymore. Got it.
Oh,
Tamika! Today is the first day she has sat up this tall by herself.
Look at her.
People won't act to solve a problem until they know that it exists.
Hands up, girl. Hands up.